Learning English helps me to get paid more.
SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways throughout Australia. My name is Josipa and you are listening to the SBS Learn English podcast, where today we are practicing phrases to help us negotiate our salaries. To negotiate something means to have talks and reach an agreement on something. So it can be very useful to know phrases to help us negotiate our salaries, because many of us have to bring home the bacon. Not that kind of bacon. To bring home the bacon is another way of saying to earn a salary, which you can then use to buy bacon. For example, you could say,
I really don't feel like going to work today, but someone's got to bring home the bacon.
Thanks, Claire. Alan is also with us today, and the two of them will help us practice phrases we can use to negotiate our salaries. Because, let's be honest, we all want to earn more, and nobody wants to be paid peanuts. If you are being paid peanuts, it means that you are being paid very little. You have a low salary or wages. By the way, a wage is a fixed regular payment earned for work or services, typically paid on a daily or weekly basis. While salary is also a fixed regular payment, but typically paid on a monthly basis and often expressed as an annual sum made by an employer to an employee. Let's hear what Claire and Alan prepared for us today. In this dialogue, Claire is an employer who has offered Alan a job, but he is not happy with the salary she is offering. Let's see how he deals with the situation.
I'm excited about the prospect of working here, and I know I'll be able to contribute a lot to the company. I really appreciate your offer, but based on the going rate for someone with my skills and experience, I'm looking for something in the upper end of that range.
Well, Alan, we look forward to working with you. But the salary we offer is fair compensation and what we have budgeted for this role.
Can you move at all on that figure? I'd feel more comfortable if we could settle on a higher base salary, because my experience and skills are worth it. Or maybe we can find a creative way to get to that number. Adding an additional week of paid vacation, for example, along with the salary you suggested, would be great. If you can do that, I'm on board.
Oh. Okay, Alan. Let me see what I can do.
Thanks, Claire. I appreciate it.
Well done, Alan. There was a moment in the dialogue where I felt he would not get what he wanted. And if you haven't understood everything they said, don't worry. We'll repeat and explain all of the phrases one by one. So let's start. Alan said he is excited about prospect of working there, and he knows he'll be able to contribute a lot to the company. He also said,
I really appreciate your offer, but based on the going rate for someone with my skills and experience, I'm looking for something in the upper end of that range.
Based on the going rate for someone with my skills and experience, I'm looking for something in the upper end of that range. This phrase shows that Alan has come to a view of what his salary should be based on the market value. That is, on what he knows other people would pay him, and not only based on what he would like to earn. When talking about salaries and wages, market value, or going rate, is the amount you should be earning based on your job title, years of experience, and skills. Do you know what a salary range is? A salary range is the minimum and maximum amount an employer pays for someone doing a particular job. For example, according to one job searching website, The average salary of an accountant in Australia is between $60,000 and $80,000. That's the salary range. $60,000 is the low end, while $80,000 represents the high or upper end of that range, the maximum you could get for that job. Alan said he's looking for...
I'm looking for something in the upper end of that range.
Well, Alan, we look forward to working with you. But the salary we offer is fair compensation and what we have budgeted for this role.
When Claire said that the salary she offered was fair compensation and what the company had budgeted for the role, she was talking about the total amount the company was willing to pay for the job. When I heard Claire's answer, I felt that Alan may not be able to get what he wanted. In his place, I wouldn't know what to say next, and the negotiation would be over. But luckily for us, Alan has more experience than me. Do you remember what he asked before giving his counteroffer? Those questions are very useful, whether you are negotiating your wages or salary, or asking for a pay rise. And do you know what counteroffer is? How about a pay rise? If you are unsure about some of these words, or how to continue your negotiation by asking the right questions, stick with us. We'll explain it after a short break. Many factors have an impact on the amount we earn and where we fit into a salary range, like our working experience, or how successful we have been in our current and past employment, because this can show off our skills. Then there is the market value, or how much other people will pay for the same type of job in the industry. Then we have our reputation, because people who come highly recommended by previous employers can easily argue for the upper end of a salary range. So it is very important that we research and prepare before we start negotiating our income. Whether we are about to start a new job or are asking for a pay rise. And this is important for two reasons. Firstly, we need to be realistic with our counteroffers. A counteroffer is an offer we make in response to an offer from our employer. And secondly, we don't want to get the short end of the stick in the deal. Getting the short end of the stick means being disadvantaged somehow, finding yourself with an outcome that is not as good as it should be. So we need to do our research and work on our confidence. And one way of doing that is by knowing what to say and what to ask. Let's learn from Alan. He said,
"Can you move at all on that figure? I'd feel more comfortable if we could settle on a higher base salary because my experience and skills are worth it. Or maybe we could find a creative way to get to that number. Adding an additional week of paid vacation, for example, along with the salary you suggested would be great. If you can do that, I'm on board."
Alan first asked,
"Can you move at all on that figure?"
Here, Alan is asking if there is any possibility to change the salary he was offered. Another question we could use
is this salary up for negotiation?
But if you don't want to sound too direct, you could say,
"Is there any room for negotiation?"
After these questions, it's good to say something that will show why they should consider giving you more money. You could use Alan's phrase when he said,
"I'd feel more comfortable if we could settle on a higher base salary."
Another phrase that shows that you are confident and that you have done your research is,
"My salary expectations are in line with my experience and qualifications."
If your salary is in line with your experience and qualifications, it suits the experience and qualifications you bring to the job. But you know what? Money is not the only thing we can. We could also ask for other benefits, like support for education and training, paid leave, vacation time, and so on. And that's what Alan did when he gave his counteroffer.
Maybe we could find a creative way to get to that number. Adding an additional week of paid vacation, for example, along with the salary you suggested, would be great. If you can do that, I'm on board.
Alan's counteroffer was asking for an additional week of paid vacation. And if you're on board with something, it means you agreed to something or you have accepted it. My guest today is Martika Terpenovska, employment solicitor from the Employment Rights Legal Service in New South Wales. Hi, Martika.
Hi, Josipa. Thank you so much for inviting me.
It's a pleasure to have you. Can you please tell us what your organization does?
So ELS, which is short for the Employment Rights Legal Service, it's a free legal service for migrants and vulnerable workers in New South Wales. And we help with problems like, for example, if you're not being paid the right amount or if you've lost your job unfairly. We also help if someone has experienced bullying or sexual harassment or discrimination at their workplace.
Can you give me an example of how you help someone?
Sure. So we do have plenty of success stories. For example, we had a lot of Brazilian cleaners who came to us for advice about being underpaid at work by the same employer. Almost all of these workers were on temporary visas and only spoke a little English. We provided advice to over 20 of these employees and calculated that they had collectively been underpaid almost $300,000. So we wrote letters and helped gather all the legal documents they needed to prove their case.
Is low levels of English often a reason why migrants are treated unfairly in their workplace?
Unfortunately, yes, this is the case, which is why there is a real need for organisations like us who help migrants with problems at work.
I'll add your link to our website, but what about our listeners from other parts of Australia, let's say Victoria, for example?
Yes, absolutely. So there is help available for workers outside of New South Wales. One example that does come to mind is JobWatch, which provides free legal assistance not only to Victorian, but Tasmanian and Queensland workers. Across Australia, there are around 170 community legal centres who provide free services to people experiencing financial hardship, discrimination, or some other form of disadvantage, or who are experiencing domestic or family violence.
It's great to know that there is help available. But, you know, as migrants, our differences are actually our strengths. Speaking more than one language means we can communicate with more people. And settling in a new country takes determination. All these things are valuable in the workplace. Thank you so much for coming in today, Martika. Can you also help us to repeat the phrases we practiced in this episode?
Of course, let's do it.
See if you remember the meaning before hearing the answer. What does it mean to bring home the bacon?
To bring home the bacon is another way of saying to earn a salary or wages.
If you are being paid peanuts, you are...
If you are being paid peanuts, you are being paid very little.
We also heard plenty of useful phrases we can use to sound confident when negotiating our salaries. Now, we don't have time to repeat all of them, so make sure you visit our website, sbs.com.au/learnenglish. And in the meantime, let's practice some questions that can help us during the negotiation process. Why don't you try repeating after Alan and Claire?
Can you move at all on that figure?
Is there any room for negotiation?
Is that salary up for discussion? Because...
Maybe we could find a creative way to get to that number.
You know that we love hearing from you. Let us know what topic you would like us to work on next. You can email us at learnenglish@.com.au or reach out on Facebook. We are SBS Learn English. I'm Josipa. Thank you for learning English with me.
This is an SBS Learn English podcast.